Hi everybody, I'm Kirsty speaking from Naio Nails. In this video, I'm going to talk to these fabulous people and teach them everything I know about nails. Maybe not everything, but I'm going to teach them as much as I can in the time we have. And we're going to start with are we doing Gothic or are we doing Russian. A Russian almond nail? So, the rotation of this bit is very important. When I come to this side, I need to flip the rotation. So, right now, it's flipping this way. So, if I come here, I want to flip it back round. I mean, to be honest, if you're using it at an angle like this, you can keep it. But because I like to keep my tool like this, I don't want to move it round because it's more difficult. You've got more chance of touching the skin and all that. I prefer to flip the rotation around. And if some of you are uncomfortable with working with a bit on the natural nail, it'll give you a little bit more confidence because you know it's not going to kick into the nail. So this is pushing everything away from the nail. So that's what I'm doing. Can you see how it's pushing it away? You'll know if it's not, the rotation's not right, because the just won't settle like that. It'll settle inside. Yeah. So I'm not digging into the nail, I'm exfoliating the skin and slightly touching the nail. So I'm not being aggressive with it, not yet anyway. So most of you know that this is really important to do. If you don't, you've got far more chance of cutting somebody, so you want to take those edges off that file. So when you rub your finger across, it's nice and smooth, yeah? So you rub it across a brand new one, it's very coarse, isn't it? So this is a 180 grit file, and Joe has a little bit of acrylic still on there. Only a tiny bit. She's done a very good job getting them off, though. When did you get these off?
Last week. Plenty of time.
Yeah. So they've had a bit of a rest. Mm. They've been able to breathe.
Yeah.
Breathing. With the lungs. Mm-hmm. The lungs of the nail. Yeah.
Bit of oxygen in there.
Yeah. How long do you normally have them,
Jo? I can go extreme.
That's fine. I wasn't going to tell you we're going to have them short anyway. I was just wondering. So do you can cope with them, can't you, long? I can't cope with them long anymore.
No, I like the long ones.
I can't because the football. I will for something special, right? I don't really have anything special. I'm sounding really depressed, aren't I, now?
Yeah. It's Monday.
I don't have anything special in my life. Just my friends and my family. The only special things. Yeah, don't single. When you cut all these, I'm still single out these videos because I'm getting Snapchats of
nice. Sharon's caring.
Lots of different shapes and sizes.
Oh, I'm with the right bend going on. Yeah, we definitely need to stop telling people I'm single. Right, so we prepped. Awesome. So these ones are mouth.
Oh boy, behind you. Like one of your admirers.
These are mouth.
Sending you a Snapchat,
like. Has everybody sculpted before?
Yeah.
If you haven't, please tell me now. It doesn't matter if
I
you
have,
haven't.
I am, but not very successful.
Yeah.
No, I'm not good at sculpting.
Yeah, I prefer tipping it. Mm-hmm. I've got tips on. It's not a bad thing. It's a quick thing. Especially on yourself. When you're not having them 10-foot long. Right, so with the sculpting foam, I am holding those tabs and I am rolling it really tight There's no point doing this. That won't do anything. You've got to roll it, get your thumbs in there and roll it nice and tight so you get a nice curve straight away before you've even put it onto the nail. I am going to close this end and leave just a little bit of a teardrop at the end. Yeah. We're going to open the back out and you're roughly going to do it as wide as the nail is. So you're going to open this out, curl with that finger. That's difficult for you to do.
It is.
God, we need starting with any duct tape. So we're anchoring the form up. When you're happy with the angle of the form, you can then close your form tight.
Mm-hmm.
Not killing your happy neck,
Kim?
No. Oh, we need to go tighter then.
Not gone numb.
So you'll start with it roughly as wide as the nail. It's all about this angle. So if you look at the side view, you can see it looks like it's pointing up. Especially with those markings on. Has anybody got a pen? I can borrow 2 secs. So the form's sticking up, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
It's going to create this gap here. When I say gap, it's not a gap between the natural nail and the form. It's like a hidden apex. That will be the thickest part of the nail. So it'll support the whole lot. Plus, because it's raising up, you have more room to come down the side. So it's going to give you a nice deep side. So you would fit the form in this way if you are going to do a square nail. So if you want, I don't know if you want to put like a little arrow pointing up, that might help you. Obviously the Russian almond, a bridge, a Blair, a fringe, I don't know why it's got that, roof, pipe, rounded square. So they are all the ones that the form will rise up, because it's going to give you your nice deep side wall. Everything else will be different, that's why I'm going to do that other shape as well, just to show you. So every system will be different, obviously. You'll all be using different systems, I'm sure, today. But with Naio, we are going to dehydrate the nail. And I'm going to use an acid-based primer because I love acid-based primers. I am so old-fashioned in that way. I just think they give a better adhesion, do you? Or not?
Yeah.
I do, and I like to have a comfort blanket, and that's my comfort blanket. I know that it's going to stick like shit to a blanket. Yeah. I'm using Max Adhesion just because it's slower. Because I'm showing you. And I want to work slower. My primer. Just on the natural nail. Right. I am going to use natural. I'm using natural because I can see it and so can you. So it's like a milky consistency. All I'm doing is making contact with the natural nail. So I'm sweeping it backwards. I'm going from side to side. And then I'm going to pull this very thin. And create a platform. So we're creating like a tip. That makes sense? So when you're doing this lateral length, you need to make sure that you are dropping these sides and creating your angle. The most important bit about this is to get it thin. So if you think, oh, it's a bit too long, that's fine. But if it's a bit too short on each side, that won't be good because it'll interfere with your shape. If it's a bit long, don't worry about it. I prefer you to press it out and get it thin, then keep dragging the product back up and building bulk. Does that make sense? Mm-hmm. And you know what, ask me questions. If you don't understand what I'm telling you, it means you're thick. No, I'm joking. I'm joking. I'm just ask me. Don't be afraid to ask. Don't be like at school when you think, oh, should have asked that question. So we've got those sides coming down. I'm just going to make sure this contact is a little bit more streamlined. And I haven't had to cut the smile line of this form to match. It fits really well. If any of you struggle with getting it nice and neat, I will come round and help you. Now I'm going to do a smile line. So I'm going to pick up a medium sized bead. That's not too wet. Placing it on with this top part, not the brush part. So the top part's pointing to the client, so it's upside down. And I'm going to feather that first before I do anything. You want to feather that before it starts to fully polymerize. So while it's still flowing. And then you can come in and start to do your smile line. So we're extending the nail bed. So she's got a nice long nail bed. If you want to concentrate on just the shape when you do yours, you don't have to do a smile line. I'm just trying to cram as many things into this class as I can for you. So now that's starting to set into it, and I'm going to use my brush quite flat and press. But what I'm building is a brick wall. So it keeps everything nice and sharp. What people are tempted to do is when they build an extended nail bed like this, they just tend to flatten it off because the brain just thinks they're doing an almond nail. So you end up flattening this area off, but you don't, you need to build that up. I'm not going to bleed out the brush of this bead. I want it to flow. Get it nice and neat at the cuticle. And you can start to bring it down. You can wet that acrylic. So that previous bead of application, you can wet that so it flows a little bit neater. This is where you're going to check, is your apex high enough? If it isn't, you're going to bang it in. You'll know if you've done your base layer thin enough because it'll still bend. If it's not bending, it's too thick because it's gone hard. It'll still bend if it's thin. Even though it's set, it'll still have flexibility. So we're going to let that set up a little bit and then we will pinch it. So when I'm coming to pinch, I'm test pinching it first. Am I still sticky? Does the product move? If it does, you're not ready. So the first point, as soon as it goes matte, test it. Don't start chatting to your mates and, oh yeah, I haven't, oh, and then go, oh, it's too late. You do all your bases first, if you did a full set, yeah? Then your smile lines. You do your smile line in this bit. So those two beads do together. And then you can be pinching this while you're applying that, pinching that while you're applying that, pinching that while you're applying that, yeah? Gonna test that again. It's not collapsing, so it's all right. Then I'm going to use my fingers to pinch through the length, because obviously the pinching tool only touches this part. The further up you go with the pinching tool, the stronger the pinch. If you really want to sharpen it even more, you can file your smile line. I wouldn't go any lower than a 150 grip file. I wouldn't use a 100 grit file because you're going to start eating into that platform. Or you could use a metal file. When you start your nail bed extension, you want to start the smile line from where the natural nail finishes. So that's your guide point. So a natural nail finishes there. And if you do that on all of them, you should have a uniform set if somebody's having the same on every nail, which not many people do now, do they? Dust that off. And then I'm going to get my monomer and clean that area with my brush. And it's also adding a little bit of monomer on there so everything will sit nice onto that nail. And shall we do it white or shall we do it
white?
Okay. You want a bit of glitter and crap? Yeah. Okay. This is when it all goes terribly wrong. Do not knock it over. Do not knock it over. Don't knock it over.
I've given up, like, trying to get rid of glitter out of my life. Office, bathroom and home, everywhere.
Yeah, I love this colour.
Yeah, man.
Vivid violet. Yeah, man. Oh my god, it's beautiful. Right, so I'm going to put a thin layer of this colour on. So I'm going right up to that smile line. Blend it down. It is really pigmented, so you can do it thin. Don't think you've got to build it up to intensify that colour. Now I really want it thin towards this tip. So I'm kind of painting it on. Clear. Now add a bit of this. And I'm going to put a bit of this on because that absolutely, oh my god, that absolutely won't work. So nice. Now we're going to cap this now. So we're just capping. Whenever you're doing clear, you don't really want to bleed the back of your brush out because you want it to flow and you want it to have minimal bubbles. Right, so I'm just making sure that's all capped. So I'm just test pinching again.
So how come you're pinching it again?
Because the when you put acrylic on top of acrylic, it softens the acrylic that's underneath. Right. So it will want to bounce out.
How would you achieve that with tips? Do you just bounce the tip?
Now, if you're doing... It's hard to do this shape with a tip, in all fairness. Yeah. I mean, you get an edge-shaped tip and just round the top off.
Yeah.
And you would make sure that when you put it on, normally with a tip, you don't want to make it sort of go like this. So you've got to make sure that when you put an edge tip on, that it is coming straight out. Because they do slightly come down a bit, so you have got that bit of an allowance to bring it up. I have done them before like that. But then pinch it once the tip's on. Once you put your... You don't have to put a clear bead down, well, a natural bead down if you're using a tip.
Oh, right.
Just go straight on with your cup of pink.
And then just bounce the tip.
Yeah. It'd be difficult to do with like a normal square tip. You can, but you'd have to really manipulate the tip. You'd have to really bend that tip in. So again, I was test pinching. So I'll be leaving that on there while I'll be doing another one now. So it overcompensated on the sides. So I knew I've got something to file against and I knew that I wasn't going to miss anything out. I did that more for your guys' benefit, really. So you can see, you've got to support this nail, it's a long nail. Now you can file both of those sides at the same time, as long as you're not going like this or like this. You can put it nice and flat, and then you can perfect them by coming in. Before I do anything else, I want to get that cuticle nice and neat. I don't want to put any pressure on that cuticle. If your cuticle isn't neat and you start to file the living hell out of this, it'll start popping at the back because the vibrations will penetrate through into that area. But I'm going to use the e-file on it now. So when I look down the barrel of this nail, I can see the thickness, so I know where I can file. So don't just get used to looking at the side view and the top view. You want to look down the side, I mean the down the barrel, and think, oh, I've got room to file there. Yes, I can make it now over there, yeah? Because you can see the thickness. So Joe will probably tell you I've got a really firm grip on a finger and I'm really pulling away that skin.
Uncomfortable.
It's not uncomfortable.
This is the kind of model we need.
It is,
not the
yeah.
windy ones we have.
Like this.
Yes.
Shut up.
So I'm wiping over with acetone to melt the top layer, which makes it even smoother. So I'm just putting the Urban Graffiti top coat on. This is a tack. Free top coat. Pop that in of the lamp. Right, so I want you to look at that nail and I want you to look at the angles so you can see it's creeping up out of the cuticle. You've got that apex in the back third and then it comes straight out. Your lower lines are coming straight from the side walls are straight. Plus you've got that C curve. The reason you've got that gorgeous big deep C curve is because we raised the form up.
It's all right.
Yeah.
I don't mind being touched.
Is there a certain amount of distance between the small line towards the up to the edge? Would you leave a certain amount of space, or is it just
it's your own preference, really? But like I say, where if you're doing your natural nail, and then we extend out. We're extending from where that natural nail finishes. Does that make sense? Mm-hmm. And then you've got your free edge. I mean, you want it to be 50-50. You don't want it too, you don't, I wouldn't want to go any more than that. Mm. Unless you were doing a photo shoot. I can't help because it'll look unbalanced. Mm. Does that make sense? But if I show you this, so can you see, if you look at the side of the nail, the smile line actually matches in with the apex. And within the nail, you have this hidden apex, don't you? Mm-hmm. You can't see it, but this hidden apex and the true apex that you see work together, so they support each other. Yeah. So the distance between here and here is the same as here and here. Whereas with the gothic one, it drops and it's shallower, shallower, shallower. Does that make sense to you? Mm-hmm. Yeah? Mm-hmm. Your angle, you want from here to here and here to be very similar. Yeah? Makes sense? Mm-hmm. Go have a go. Go have a go, girls.
Yeah.
This form needs to be raised up, whereas it's not, is it?
No, I think it's because of the tip.
So you make a lovely stiletto with it then.
Well, that's not bad then.
With the side walls going straight out, you will make a nice stiletto. So, what you can do is you can drop them down and create a different shape now. So you put it on that way. And you feather, 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 feather. Obviously, this would fit in the first two. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Well, guys, I hope you've enjoyed that video of the Russian almond. Have a go. See how you get on. I have this crazy lot behind me. The day is nearly over. See you in the next video. Bye-bye.
That was melt, by the way.
Melt. If you do not understand my broad Stokey accent, please tell me.